I'm not a police officer, but I'm not a social worker. I'm right down the middle. I'm a probation officer.
As soon as you walk in the door, that's usually the first thing that you're going to see is the wall of change.
It just struck me as a great idea. I went to a training out in Texas, and then I brought it back to the staff here. I asked some people to take leadership in the role of it, Dave Cole being the leader.
Somebody who's come into probation, they look at the wall of change and maybe see somebody that's on there that they used to run with. They read their story and found out he's successful now. He's got a job and a house and a wife and a kid and a car, and he's doing all these great things. That person who didn't see that for himself can say, wow, if he can do it, I can do it.
I start dabbling with marijuana, alcohol, right around 12 years old.
I was an addict, a heroin addict for many years. I was only 15 years old.
It's really a tough time in your life because you're looking for that acceptance, you want to fit in.
I didn't know I was doomed from there, but pretty much I was doomed from there.
I was one of them that did turn to the peer pressure of the in crowd. Matter of fact, that's actually where I first got a taste of the alcohol and, you know, marijuana and stuff like that.
Instead of going to class, what I used to do is sit at the top of Meet Theater. You know, Meet Theater, they still have it there, right? You sit at the top of Meet Theater with a sack of weed in one pocket and just sell weed all day.
What's meaningful to me is that you can have somebody come into your office with a multitude of problems and you help turn that life around.
We get a number of different types of individuals. So what we try to do as probation officers is connect people with services that are going to help them succeed and complete probation successfully, but also to be a positive member in society.
It's the person doing the work, but if you can be a part of that, if you have assistance to that, and get that person turned around so they're like those people at the wall of change, you've really made it as a probation officer.
I've always had problems with substance abuse. Both of my parents were alcoholics, and that led and caused me to grow up in foster care at a young age.
This completion of probation and Prop 36 and the wall of change is very, very important.
I was sent to prison for a total of 32 months. I went through probation successfully, and this was important to remain off drugs.
Here I was incarcerated, and I woke up one Saturday morning and I looked across the pod and I saw what appeared to be me in another cell. And I looked, I said, oh, that guy looks like me. And I looked again and I said, wow. And it was my son.
My turning point was when I finally had hit rock bottom and I had lost custody of my children.
It's scary. It's scary. I thank God. I thank God that I walked away from that life.
That kind of opened my eyes. Somebody has to break this cycle. Somebody has to change.
There are services out there that are willing to help people.
I don't know how to improve the wall of change, quite frankly. It is a well-oiled machine.
By connecting the defendants with these services is just awakening them and letting them be more aware that they make some positive changes with that.
I need more wall space, quite frankly. We're having a meeting next week to figure out, hey, we have more frames than space. What are we going to do now?
Today, I have my own apartment, my own car. 2009 Chevy, HHR, tenant windows, all that.
Today I'm proud to say that I'm a clean and sober mother. I have regained custody of my children, full-time employment, and I have also been meeting the needs of my probation.
Just shows growth, you know, and it's taken a long time, but I'm finally growing up, finally being a responsible, productive member of our society.
So that was the hardest thing for me, to just kind of like pull away from old associates and, you know, really do things differently. And if I was having like a moment of breakdown where I was just feeling that urge, come on, you really had to learn to be strong and call on your support systems.
Oh, that's a really tough question. My favorite part, I think, is maybe just seeing somebody who I've worked with, and I see they're off of probation now, and I see them out on the streets when I'm working, you know, going out in the field or something, and they'll come up to me, approach me, and just tell me, hey, Dave, how you doing? You know, I'm doing this, I'm doing that. And, you know, they're continuing to do well. But it's not even about, my favorite part isn't about me getting thanked. It's more about seeing them being successful.
The happiest I've been in my whole life is being clean and sober and being free. Okay, I think going to prison saved my life. I want to thank Officer David Cole, who had faith in me to believe in me. Thank you very much. And I'm so proud to receive this.
The most important thing I've learned in recovery, and I guess it's one of those slogans that we always say,
I'm always focused. And that's one thing that we say when we're in the program. Focus up. Focus.
Take a couple of steps back. Take a couple of deep breaths and say, oh, I lost my focus. Let me regain my focus.
You can't keep using and expecting that things are going to turn out different or it's going to work this time, because it just doesn't.
You have to focus in life, because if you don't, you'll slip away. Get everything out of life that you can. I mean, you know, and it's you. You're the one that can say yes or no. And don't say yes, because if you do, you're an idiot.
Good job, Tony. Yeah.
Thanks, David. I'm sorry about, you know, I'm a Pisces, I'm a very emotional, and I'm just happy.
That's nothing to apologize for, kid.
No, it's not.
You want me to put my gun on the table and make you really nervous?